So hello and welcome back to my channel. As you can see, I have a very special guest here today. This is my husband, Andy. He is going to be talking about his favorite products, and I just thought this would be a fun video to do for Valentine's Day. So happy Valentine's Day, everybody. And Andy, you can take it away.
Great,
you want to start talking about your favorite products?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me. This is pretty exciting.
You're welcome.
And you know, it's kind of cool. I have to give Trish credit because I used to kind of blow a lot of this thing off as, you know, kind of silly, but I have to admit that, you know, I think I underappreciated how nice it is to kind of take care of your hair and skin and make your armpits, you know, make sure it doesn't, you don't BO, things like that. So in terms of my hair, might as well start from the top down. And so I would say, you know, I've had trouble with my hair, mostly because it can be super frizzy. I mean, I'm happy I have hair, so I guess I should be thankful for that. But
you do have coarse, thick hair.
Very, very, yeah, exactly. Very, very coarse, thick hair. And
coarse.
Coarse. Of course. Coarse.
Coarse or coarse.
But I do need to kind of make sure it's under control. So Trish has given me so many different oils. I mean, dozens and dozens of different oils. But there are certain oils that I have no idea why, but you kind of can style it a little bit easier with the oil. It smells nicer. And it's just, there's some nuance that happens with hair oils that I was really surprised about. So I kind of landed.
You've been using them for like 8 years now, I think.
Oh, yeah,
it's been a long
time
that you've been enjoying the hair oil.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. But I'm set on oil. Oils, especially if you have coarse hair. If there are guys listening to this or women and you have coarse hair, you know, oils are a way to go. So do you want to show this particular one?
Yeah, let's
one?
Do let's it. See. You can start talking about it.
Actually, well, I never even noticed. It's called Sahara Rose.
Yeah, Divine. It's their Divine Beauty Serum. I think it's for the, yeah, it says here for body and hair. Let's show you the product. So you can use it for your body or hair, but I gave it to Andy to use for his hair.
Oh, so I can use this on my body too. I didn't realize
that. Yeah, you
that.
Can. And then okay. I also, the other one you've been using that you're almost out of is, this is from Ode to Self. This is their Dusk body and hair oil. So I think actually you probably didn't realize this, but you'll see a lot of hair oils are, you know, formulated for hair or body.
Hmm. Yeah, I like both of these for sure. I don't know why, but I kind of like dark bottles. I don't know why that is. It's kind of weird. But so I do, you know, depending on how short my hair is or if I got a haircut, you know, three, you know, squeezes, spritzes, and
pumps.
And, you know, usually I don't know if it's, you know, you're supposed to do it a certain way or not. I think I saw on some TV show how to do it where you know.
Oh, that would be Queer Eye.
Yeah, Queer Eye, yeah.
Yeah, JVN taught you how to put hair oil on.
Yeah, where you just kind of go this way, and then I go through the hair this way, and then, you know, kind of get it. And then sideburns, you can do that, sideburns, and even your eyebrows, which
is
kind of nice.
Wow, I didn't know you were doing that.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, you can, like, you do that, and then it just kind of tames the eyebrows. Because as you get older, you know, you get these wiry, kind of like Mark Twain, bizarre eyebrows. So.
So you like both of these?
Yeah, I like both of these.
Pretty equally well?
I like both of these.
I like the smell, the Ode to Self one, it's called Dusk. It smells really good. I like there's vetiver in here.
But I have to say, this smell is the best.
Oh, so you like the Sahara Rose?
Out of all the different smells, smell is really
good.
All
right.
Really,
I didn't
really
realize
nice.
That. Yeah. Okay, so you start with your hair oil. You want to talk about shaving? What you like to use for shaving?
Yeah, well, first of all, I don't like to shave. Most men, and I guess women, if they shave, you know, they don't like shaving. I don't like to shave. In fact, I'll grow a beard. I'll be going for a week or 2 weeks, and Trish finally.
Until I start to complain loudly about it.
And it bothers me. It gets super itchy. Anyway, shaving is no fun, but you can make it fun by doing certain things.
And well, start with what you like to, you know, condition your beard, you were saying, and then you can end with this one.
Yeah. So he likes
oils for shaving, right?
I do like oils, but I have to say that, and this is a little trick, which is something I've learned over the years, that if you're going, you know, 5-7 days and you kind of have a beard and you know, you're going to shave it, and you want it to be nice and like almost buttery to shave, because if you kind of, you know, trim off the millimeter of hair and then either, you know, warm water or even like shampoos or even soaps just to kind of scrub things in before you put in the oil. It gets through, like you took like that top layer of hair and it almost like it absorbs into the hair. So the hair becomes like buttery almost, like we're super soft and easy to shave. You don't have to kind of, you know, fight to shave. And it, that's the thing that people hate about shaving is that feeling like you're gonna, you know, you're pulling at the hair no matter how good of a razor you have. So if you make your hair nice and buttery feeling and you shave, it's super satisfying. And the combination of either like shampoo or that bar, what's that bar?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I gave him one of the Meow Meow Tweet shampoo bars.
Oh, so I'm using a Meow Meow?
Meow product? Meow Tweet is okay. The name of the brand.
Okay. So once I get that Meow Meow stuff on my face, and you really like kind of take the bar and do that. Anyway, then when you shave, it's amazing. Plus the oil. So you want to show this,
yeah,
oil.
Yeah, so this is the one from L'Amour. And this is their, I think it's just called the Organic Facial Oil. It is marketed towards men. I think that's in focus there. So yeah, so this is it. And actually, yeah. I did write down the ingredients in this shaving oil or the men's facial oil. It's got olive oil, thyme oil, and thyme is actually has antiseptic qualities, so maybe that's why you like it too. Huh. Avocado oil, carrot oil, rose hip seed oil, and then there's also peppermint in there. And do you find that peppermint oil like bothers you in any way or causes irritation, or do you like it?
I guess I kind of like it. Yeah, it's kind of the cooling sensation. Yeah. And then after you shave, it's kind of nice after you shave, you know, you kind of have that little bit of an oily feeling and then you can wash it off. But probably the most helpful thing, so at that point, you know, very satisfied, it feels great, you know, the shave is kind of fun to do as opposed to really kind of torture.
So what do you do? So you condition it with like shampoo or whatever, and then do you dry that off and then put the oil on dry skin?
No, I actually add the oil with everything.
Oh,
it's kind of
okay.
Nice because you can feel the oil mix and I don't know, it just feels good.
I got it now.
Then you shave, the shave is great. And then afterwards, a lot of guys, you know, will get little, you know, bumps, tiny little pimples, ingrown hair, razor burn, and almost every time for most guys, there's a little bit here and there. Sometimes it could be really bad depending, but the something I do every single time and it prevents any kind of bumps or razor burn or anything is you basically take azelaic acid, like generic. We don't have it.
Well,
here,
so you can keep talking about the azelaic acid, but what I have here to show you guys, and I think you use this sometimes, maybe not frequently,
not as much.
But is the Ordinary, and this has 10% azelaic acid, and then we have a prescription that's 20%, but that is ridiculously expensive.
Oh, yeah.
And so we move to the generic 15%. So I think I've mentioned this before, but you and the boys really like to use the azelaic acid, you for the razor burn,
right,
and then the boys for, you know, blemishes. And I actually use it when I have a blemish.
Yeah, no, I think it's great. And it's just great. It's also, I don't know what it is. You know, the other thing is after you shave, when you put azelaic acid on there, you feel like a little bit of a burn, but it does
have a little bit of a tingly sensation.
Yeah, a little tingly, but
it's not
satisfying.
Causing any harm.
No, no harm. My skin never, but the main thing is after I do the azelaic acid, I never have even the tiniest little pimple afterwards.
It's amazing stuff.
Yeah, I do that after I shave. I do that every time.
Sure. So this is actually Live Botanical. This is their original packaging. And actually, so we've had this for a while. You probably don't use this as much, or maybe you don't use a lot of drops, but anyway, it's actually
like
still good.
Drops.
It has not gone off. So even though we probably had this for a couple years, it still is totally fine. And then just to let you know before Andy starts talking about it, I think, so it's called the Awaken Clearing Oil. That's the new name of it. And it has pumpkin seed oil, calendula, black caraway seed oil, which apparently is really good for acne, and then sunflower seed oil. So that's what's in it. But how do you like to use it?
Well, so what I do is I just, you know, put 3 or 4 drops into my palm, and then I just kind of rub my palm, get it on 3 fingers or so. And then, you know, I'll just kind of rub in my forehead first and kind of like all the way up just underneath my hair line, and then on the sides and kind of around the eyes, not really on the nose. I don't ever feel like I want an oily nose. It seems kind of weird. So I avoid the nose.
Yeah.
And then I've already put azelaic acid on my face, so I don't want to do that. So it's.
But you can though. That's the good thing. You can actually put moisturizer on top of azelaic acid.
Okay.
Yeah, well, you can do that.
I learn things every time I do these. So I'm going to do that in the future. And the other nice thing about the oil on the face, I don't know why, it's soothing. I think it's kind of nice to have like a little bit of a shine on your face.
You like the glow.
Yeah, you glow. So it's nice to feel like you're glowing. So after the whole experience, you get the hair thing going, you got, you know, the azelaic acid, no, you're not gonna have any pimples, your face is glowing, you feel good. You're ready for dinner, you're ready to start the day. Now, the next thing I think we need to talk about.
Okay, so on the days you're not shaving, how do you like to cleanse your skin?
Oh.
Do you like this one?
Yeah, I do.
I think you've been enjoying it.
I do. It's just, I mean, it's a rose water daily cleansing something.
Yeah, look at you. The good molecules, rose water daily cleansing gel. So question for you. You like foaming cleansers, right? I don't think I've been able to get, we'll talk about the good molecules. So that's this right here. But before we talk about that one and the foaming cleanser, have you tried like cream cleansers or the oil cleansers?
Yeah, I'm not a fan. If I'm washing my face, I want to feel like it's actually getting soapy and.
You like the psychological feeling of foam?
Yeah, I want to feel like I'm actually cleaning something, you know, as opposed to sometimes oil, you feel like all you're doing is you're spreading dirt around your face.
Okay, but which is not the case.
I know, but you like
what you like.
It's a psychological thing. Yeah. I like to feel like I'm using soap on my face.
Right. That's totally fine. And do you feel like this one is not drying like after you use it? Because you don't want to have that squeaky clean feeling.
No.
You want to feel like it's been nourished.
Well, now that you bring that up, actually, it's true that sometimes you use regular soap. It does. It feels dry, especially in the wintertime.
Yeah, you don't want to be dry.
That I don't feel that happen.
So this feels pretty gentle for you.
I didn't realize that. Yeah.
Okay. That's good to know.
So I'm going to use this more now that I feel better about it.
Instead of what were you using before?
Ivory soap.
No, you weren't.
So the last part, it doesn't go too long. Head. So got everything going, but now the pits are super important because I have kind of stressful work and, you know, I can sweat at work. And so.
Don't let them see you sweat.
Well, and you don't, you know, there's enough smells going on where I work. The last thing you want is another bad smell.
You don't want
yourself.
Own. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Because yeah. That's the one thing you have control over. I don't have control over other people's smells. I have control over my smell. So I've tried so many different deodorants. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. Conventional and, you know, green beauty ones.
Everything. And what's crazy is the best one is like, this, you can explain what this is.
Yeah. This one that I make.
Yeah.
I make it for them. It's a DIY, super simple deodorant. So yeah. I'll tell you what's in it. It's just, I literally just made up this new one like 2 days ago.
Yeah,
so
I watched you do it.
Yeah, it has 3 tablespoons of coconut oil, 2 tablespoons baking soda. So if you're sensitive to baking soda, this is not the DIY recipe for you. So 3 of coconut oil, 2 tablespoons of baking soda, 2 tablespoons of arrowroot. And then I like to put in this, I don't know if you're gonna see the texture here. That's what it looks like. And then I put in 10 drops of cedar essential oil because I just think I love the smell of it.
Yeah, that is
it. Smells amazing.
Yeah, I can smell it. It's good. It's good. But you know, what's crazy about this stuff is I don't know. I mean, it feels nice to massage something into your armpit instead of, you know, rolling something around, hair gets caught and it could be a mess. But what's nice is that you massage it in, you've done it, you know, with your own hand. It's kind of something.
As opposed to somebody else applying it for you. I guess I could do it for you.
You could. Yeah,
but you get up a lot earlier than I do.
Yeah, and it's it actually is nice.
It's self-care. It's your self-care of when you put on your deodorant. You're taking care of yourself.
And your armpit is your armpit.
It's
another, you know, important part of your body that we ignore. It's kind of like armpits and feet kind of are in the same category. But the bottom line is I can go through the most stressful shift and at the end I'm being honest here. I do not smell.
Yeah, I can vouch for that.
Yeah, I get home.
You don't smell when you come home.
No. So this stuff is crazy how good. And it's inexpensive, right? I mean, arrowroot.
Baking soda and coconut oil.
So anyway, so that's my regimen.
Yeah, nice.
You know, from head to toe. And
Well, not really head to toe. We just talked about head to pit.
Head to pit, that's true, head to pit. I just was the pit and the feet category thing.
Yeah, exactly.
But the bottom line is I used to not appreciate all this stuff, but it really does feel nice to just smell good, have nice hair, skin, you know, and all the rest. So
and have your glow.
I want to thank my wife, Trish.
for introducing
me and helping me and
nice skincare.
Yeah, it affects your mood, you know, it improves. I think it improves your mood, self-esteem, all aspects when you're taking care of yourself. And I used to blow it off and I don't do that anymore.
Yeah, I agree. All right,
so
well, nice
you.
Work, Andy.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us, and thank you for watching. And if you have any self-care questions for Andy that you would like him to address, just leave your comments or questions down below. And if you enjoyed this, then maybe he'll make another appearance.
Thanks for having me. This has been fun, actually.
All right. We'll see you guys later.
Bye-bye.